Hi. So I got inspired to research public perceptions about 2 years ago when I was at home in India with my family. So my father comes back home one day and he's not feeling well, so he goes to the doctor, gets a fancy 70 antibiotic prescription, comes back home and he's flashing it everywhere. He starts taking it. 3 days into the treatment, he stops. And the reason is very simple. I ask him and he says, "I don't feel the need to take it anymore. I feel fine." And honestly, why should we have to take any more antibiotics than we actually need? Let's take an example. Suppose you're suffering from pain and you've been in pain for a while now, and you're on painkillers. If you wake up one morning and you have no pain, you most likely won't take your painkillers that day. And that's okay, no harm done. Antibiotics are different. Antibiotics are designed to kill bacteria. That means if you just take it until the symptoms go away, that doesn't mean you're cured. That means that the amount of bacteria in your body have been reduced to the point that you don't feel sick anymore. So if you keep doing that, the bacteria in your body are getting used to the antibiotics, and a point will come when the bacteria will absolutely not respond to the antibiotics, and you've developed yourself some antibiotic resistance. And that's a big problem, right? So when I came to Brown about a year ago, they offered me the option, and it's a fantastic program. So they absolutely said, you know, you could pick any topic you want to research, and I picked public perceptions of antibiotic prescriptions and how it leads to resistance. I'm qualitatively assessing thoughts and feelings. During the summer, I conducted about 30 interviews in India, in Noida, a place that I grew up in, and I talked to people one-on-one. I started analyzing the data a few months ago, and I found three very interesting things. So when a person goes to the doctor and you're prescribed antibiotics, your doctor tells you what antibiotics you're going to take, for how long you're going to take them, and what they're for. Has your doctor ever mentioned what happens if you don't finish your prescription? Never. Second, and you know what? Just to remind you, I was a dentist. I used to practice dentistry in India, and I've done that a million times, so, and that was a big mistake. Second, when a person goes to the doctor and is prescribed antibiotics, in the United States, you go to the pharmacy, you pick up a bottle with the exact number of pills you need, come back home and start taking it, and it's all entered into the fancy database, right? It's centralized, so you know it's there. In India, it's different. You go to the pharmacy, buy how much you want. A lot of antibiotics are over the counter, so nobody really is keeping track of how many are going. So that's another problem, lack of adherence. Third, there's a general feeling that people believe the more antibiotics you take, the more harm it's going to cause you. So, lack of awareness. I want there to be an intervention designed to bridge the gap between what gets communicated when a doctor talks to the patient and what the patient understands. I want it to be protocol that a doctor has to communicate what antibiotic resistance is to a patient when a patient gets prescribed antibiotics. And it's important, isn't it? I've been talking about antibiotic resistance for a few minutes now, and you're probably wondering why. I mean, there are so many bigger problems on the planet. The thing is, it affects every one of us, and we just don't notice it. You read it in passing in the newspapers and just don't think about it twice. Let me take an example from India. Tuberculosis. About 3 million people suffer from tuberculosis in India, and it's a really big problem. The treatment for tuberculosis is very simple. Four to nine months of antibiotic prescriptions twice daily, and that's it. That's simple, antibiotics. Imagine taking antibiotics for 4 to 9 months, antibiotics that have side effects. So what people do is, the moment they start feeling better, they stop taking their antibiotics. That leads to antibiotic-resistant tuberculosis. The WHO conducted a survey. 3.6% of those 3 million people suffer from multiple drug-resistant tuberculosis, and 6% suffer from extremely drug-resistant tuberculosis. It means there's no cure at all. The problem with resistant TB is it spreads just like normal TB. So you could be spreading resistant TB to your family, your children, and your friends, and everybody you meet. And that's a problem. On this planet, we're battling communicable and non-communicable diseases, and we read about it every single day. I believe antibiotic resistance is an equally big problem. And that's why my research matters. So thank you.